כן, now we're in Aseres in Tshuva, and everybody would know that if Chas v'Shalom there is a bad gzeira, we should nullify it. And then we have a lot of prayers by Avinu Malkeinu, Karo Egzar Dineinu, by the davening of Yom Minoroim, we say over there, Tshuva, Tfilo, Tzedakah, Ma'avirin, Estroya, Gzeira. So that the way, Lechoira, the way you nullify the gzeira, the way you tear the gzeira is by tefillah, tshuva, utzdokah. L'chayre, that's how it goes. However, there's another thing that the Gemara and Rosh Hashanah talks about it, that there is a gezeira that comes with a shvua. That when Hashem said a gezeira with a shvua, the Gemara says you cannot get rid of this gezeira. Gatavi, there is a decree, and Hashem put this decree under an oath. You cannot get rid of the gzeira. That's what the Gemara says over here. Kan begzar din sheesh bo imo shvua, kan begzar shani mo shvua. The Gemara says, kid Rav Shmuel bar Ami, da omar Rav Shmuel bar Ami, vamri lo omar Rav Shmuel bar Nachmani, omar Rav Yoinason, minayin le gzar din sheesh imo shvua, she'en no miskareya. If the God forbid there is a gzar din, a decree, comes under an oath, not just a decree, with an oath, with a shvua, and a miskareya. You cannot get rid of it. You cannot tear that decree. It's have to come true. God forbid. So how you deal with it? The Chora we know. And the Chadover Dover Homid b'fnat Shuvah. The Gemara brings a raya from Shmuel Aleph. Lochen ishbati lebes Eli with the ayin that was the Kohen Godel time of Shiloh. It says over there Hashem was not happy with his children, and he says like this: there's a curse on his children. It says over there, "V'lochon ishbati lebes eli mischaper avoin bes eli bezevach ubemincha." So it says over there, even if they're gonna do tshuva and they're gonna bring zevach umincha, they're gonna bring korbanos, Hashem says, "I'm not forgiving them." So it comes out there is some horrible decrees, very severe ones. That Hashem says, Nishbati lebes eli, shvua. Hashem says, I give an oath. That says, even you bring korbanos, you do tshuva, zevach umincha, and a mischaper. The Gemara says, Amar Rabba. Rabba says, however, there's a little, the light at the end of the tunnel. Zevach umincha, and a mischaper. If you're going to bring korbanos and do tshuva with the korbanos, obviously with the tshuva, it's not going to bring kapara. Aval mischaperu b'divre Torah. We see from here, from the Gemara, that the koyach of Torah, the koyach of learning Torah, it's even greater than korbanos, even such a decree. That the pasuk says, there's no kapara for it. There's no, you cannot tear the gezeira, you cannot nullify this gezeira, even with tshuva and korbanos. The Gemara says, through Torah you could do it. So when we do kaporas before Yom Kippur, it's at the best, it could be similar to a korban at the best, like it should be replace you. If God forbid there is a gezeira, if there is a decree with a shvua, that would not help. What would help? Torah. The Gemara says, how do we know? The Gemara says, Abaye, oh, so that's as Rabbi says, you need Torah. Abaye Omar, bezevach ubemincha en amiskaper. Amiskaper ubetoyro begmilas chasadim. Abaye, the Talmud of Rabbah, said, no, you need two things in order to have a kapora for such a severe decree that comes with a shvua, with an oath. You need toyro and gmilas chasadim. Gmilas chasadim, the definition of gmilas chasadim, it's not just tzedakah. Either gmilas chasadim begufoy, that then you go big. Tzedakah it's with money. Gemilas chasadim it's you do with your body. You go mevaker choyle, you visit somebody that's not well. You go help somebody physically. You're going to lo aleinu to do chesed with somebody that needs an levaya. Or you go you do gemilas chasadim when you go help chasen kala when you go and mesameach them and chasen. Also gemilas chasadim part of gemilas chasadim when you give people money. A free interest loan. Gemilas chasad, gemach, what we call gemach. So those things, Abaye said, you need Torah, learning a lot of Torah, you need gemilas chasadim, that would mechaper, even the decree comes with a shvua. The Gemara brings now, a proof lamaisa from it. The Gemara says the Rabbah va'Abaye, the Rebbe, Rabbah with the hay, and Abaye, the Talmud, the boat with the base Eli Ka'osu. The boat were Kehanim. The boat came from the home of Eli HaKoyen. And Eli HaKoyen, as we just learned, there was a big bad decree on them. And as we're going to see soon, the decree was Marbis Beischo Yamusu Anoshim. Hashem said most of people coming from this family will die, young people, up to 18 years old. Lo aleinu. They're growing up to, boom. It's a tragedy. And the Gemara says, the Abaye with the best Eli Ka'osu, Rabbe the Osak B'Toyra, Rabbe, he learned a lot of Torah. He was a big, one of the biggest Amoroim. He was the Rebbe of Abaye V'Rove. He was the Rebbe. And he lived, instead of 18, he prolonged his life by 22 years. Chaya Arboin Shnin. He lived 40 years. And the words Chus of Torah. The Gemara says, Abaye, his Talmud, also was from the same family of Bes Eli. The Osag B'Toyra of Gemilus Chasodim. Abaye was busy with both, learning Torah and doing Gemilus Chasodim. Chaya Shitin Shnin. He lived 60 years. He prolonged his life by 42 years. And the Toys verse brings over here, obviously, Rabbi also did Chasodim. He also was involved in the Gemilus Chesed, but wasn't like Abaye. Abaye was mainly Rabbi was immersed in Torah. Abaye was involved in both of them heavily. And the Zchus of Torah, Gemilus Chasodim, took the decree that Hashem says you cannot get rid of this decree. Yeah. Even that you could bypass. How? Torah Gemilus Chasodim. It's hard work. It's not like something, you know, you take a chicken and you do kaporas with it. That takes a lot of effort. You have to learn Torah to do Gemilus Chasodim. But even such a decree that Hashem says most of the people will die early. So Rabbi was able to prolong it 22 years. Abaye was able to prolong it 42 years. So the Gemara brings over there, the Gemara says, Mishpacha achas oisam Yerushalayim. There was a Mishpacha in Yerushalayim. Show you Meseya, Mesim b'nei Shmenes Reshono. Lo aleinu, the children of that family used to die at the age of 18. Come to 18 and people knew they're dying. Ubo v'odis Rabbi Chanan ben Zakkai. They came to Rabbi Chanan ben Zakkai, says, what's going on over here? We need to do something. Omar lo, Rabbi Chanan ben Zakkai told them, Shema Mishpachas Bes Eli Atem. Maybe from the family of Bes Eli. Dechsiv, most of the people of this family will die. Anoshim, meaning young man, which is 18. It says, L'chuv isko b'toyra v'chiyu. He told him, go learn Torah and you're going to live longer. V'holchu v'osko b'toyra v'oyuk. They went back and they learned Torah. They became more involved in learning. And they lived longer. And they called this whole family Mishpachas Rabbi Yochanan al Shmoy. They started calling them after Rabbi Yochanan because with this advice, he gave them the advice to prolong the life because of Rabbi Yochanan. They lived longer. They called them the family of Rabbi Yochanan. So we see from here, and then during especially Aseret Simchat, we're all davening Hashem Kra Roye Gzar Dineinu. Yeah, davening is important, kaporas is important to do, a lot of things are important, but if we involve in Torah, in Gemilus Chasodim, we could tear the worst decree, even the decree with the Shvuah, tear it with the koyach of Torah, Gemilus Chasodim.